So good evening. We are back again, the first of two transfer videos today. Make sure you check out the one that will be dropping at 11 p.m. UK time as well. Aaron Ramsey is surplus to requirements at Juventus. Oh, bring Aaron back. Oh, Sentiment FC. We can pair him up with Jack Wilshere. Turn it in. So make sure you come and check that out a little bit later. Also, we'll be speaking about Eddie Nketiah because Crystal Palace may just be looking to purchase him in this January transfer window. They have terminated a contract for Mateta, not Arteta. Maybe we could cancel his contract and terminate his. So make sure you come and check that out, 11 p.m. UK time. Make sure also you go and check out the video I did earlier. Our game in the Carabao Cup semi is called off. Gav from LFC Daytrip has joined me on that stream. So make sure you go and check that out. We've got a Liverpool perspective because I was not happy. And he came on and explained it in great depth and length. And it kind of makes sense. But go and check that out as well. Make sure you stick a like on the video. Make sure you are following all the socials. Links are in the description. Follow the second channel. I will be uploading. I know I keep saying that, but I will be uploading and streaming on there real soon. And let's talk about Florian Balogun first off. Middlesbrough are in the driving seat to sign Florian Balogun. I struggle saying that geezer's name. Is it just me? Is it just me that has problems with that? Maybe the Cruz Campos have not gone down too well. I don't know. But apparently a loan deal to Middlesbrough is very close to being agreed within Arsenal and Middlesbrough. And it's probably for the best, if we're being completely honest. He's not going to get any game time at Arsenal. So it's probably best that he does go on loan. And latest reports suggest that it's all pretty much done. It's just got to be signed off. And then he'll be heading off to Middlesbrough, and he'll be on loan there until the end of the season. Now, it's a bit of a weird one, this, because he signed a new contract and there was umming and ahhing. And he was looking to get out of the club, according to reports. And eventually he signed a new contract. Now, the reason that stalled for so long was because he wanted game time. And he's had no game time. And then the game he did play, we dumped him out on the left wing and basically fed him to the Wolves against Sunderland. So, yeah, it's probably for the best that he does go. Hopefully he can go there and start slapping some goals in and come back to us fit and raring to go for the new season. Because I think there's a player there. I really do. I think there's a proper player there. And I think that if you utilise him properly, play him up front, not on the wing. Like, our manager loves to play strikers on the wing. I don't really understand it, if I'm completely honest, but it is what it is. But yeah, hopefully he can go there. I don't imagine the loan fee would be massive. I can't imagine that there'd be against paying his wages. I can't imagine he's on massive wages either, if I'm honest. So yeah, good luck to him. If that goes through, which it does look like it's going to, then totally good luck to him, because he deserves to go and play football. And chopping and changing him in the squads, then putting him back in the under-23s, then in the squads not playing under-23s, it's no good for his development. And like I said, I think we've got a good player on our hands there. But now he's got to go out and he's got to prove it, and he's got to start scoring goals for Middlesbrough if that is where he ends up. So yeah, good luck to him. Good luck to him. Next player is Isak. And we've been linked to this player for what seems like an eternity. And obviously all of our fans are getting hyped and buzzed up. Arsenal are in pole position for Isak. Alexander Isak to the carpet to team up and rekindle the partnership that him and Martin Odegaard had at Real Sociedad when he was on loan and partnered up with Isak. I love how these fans live in a fantasy world. It's amazing, isn't it? It's hilarious. Just because they've done it at Real Sociedad doesn't mean in any way, shape or form that they're going to do it at Arsenal. But he's apparently available. What that means is that if you come in with the right price, you can have him, because every player is available. You just got to pay the right money for him. Now, listen, he ain't having the greatest of seasons. He scored 4 league goals in 16 appearances this season. Maybe, just maybe, that's because he's got his eye off the ball because he wants a move. Total appearances, 23 in all comps and 8 goals. 3 of them, Europa League, 1 in the Copa del Rey, 4 in the league. Couple of assists. He's played in the right wing one game this season, scored 1 goal. The rest have been as a striker. His record overall for Real Sociedad is 112 games, 41 goals, 7 assists. So it's not really a lay it on the plate for his teammate type of guy by the looks of it. And listen, I used to watch La Liga religiously. I don't watch it anymore, if I'm honest. As soon as they all started diving around on the floor in the El Clasico, I stopped watching it. But they're currently sat seventh in the table, and they are literally 3 points off of third place. That's how tight that league is. They were top for quite a while at the start of the season. So, I don't, like I said, I don't watch Real Sociedad. I don't watch La Liga. They stopped the rot. They'd had four straight losses before the last game, which they ended up drawing. But yeah, a lot of people that come in my chat, a lot of people that I see on social media do highly rate this guy. I mean, the money, touted is mad. Transfer Market have him down at 40 mil. He is only 22 and he is a Swedish international. I don't know if that makes any difference to the price, but being an international these days, it's pretty simple, isn't it? You have a couple of good games, you're straight away called up as an international player. So I wouldn't read necessarily too much into that. His record for Sweden, 31 appearances, 8 goals. It's hardly ripping up trees. But again, he is only a young lad. And if we want to go down the Project Youth road, then maybe this is the type of signing that we do need. I don't know. We obviously clearly need a striker. And he is somebody, like I said, that has been linked to Arsenal for, 18 months or so now. And I've seen prices last summer for like 70 million quid. Obviously, in Spain, everyone has a buyout clause. It's tied to their contract. So it covers the selling club, protects their value, like we did with Rob Holding. But 70 million pound is apparently what his buyout clause is. Now, he ain't going to go for 70 million quid. Nobody really goes for their buyout clause in Spain. Like I said, it's just to protect the club that's selling them. But if we was to get him for around 40 million quid, is that good business? I don't really know. Like I said, I don't really watch that league. Because, like I said, it just turns into a dive fest and waving, oh, get your yellows out, get your yellows out. Listen, his record is pretty decent in that league. But at the same time, it is the Spanish La Liga. And you've got teams in there that you can just slap goals past for fun. What's the record against the big teams? Like, is he doing it in the big games? Is he doing it in the games that mean the most? Obviously, every game means something. But is he doing it in the biggest of games every season? And that is what you have to look at. I'm going through it now against Real Madrid last season. No goals, no assists. Played 62 minutes, hooked. We then go to Valencia. Maybe that's a big game. No goals. He was on the bench for three out of four games in a row. Scoring against Huesca. He scored against Cadiz. He scored against Levante. I mean, these teams, they're right down the bottom of the table. Barcelona, no goals, no assists. Real Betis, I mean, they've had a resurgence since Becky B's gone there. He's given them an upturn in defensive form. They're currently third in the table, but he scored and got an assist in that. Villarreal, he got a goal. Cadiz, again, he got two. Getafe, one. Hat-trick against Alaves. I mean, Real Madrid, no goals. Like, Barcelona, no goals. Where are we? Atletico Madrid, no goals. Osasuna, one. Valladolid, two. Eibar. I mean, to me, just looking at it, and you guys that do watch that league, you guys that are more on the ball with some of these foreign players, let me know. Because to me, looking at his record, he had 17 goals last season in the league in 34 appearances, which is 1 in 2. It's pretty good. But it looks to me like he's just stat padding against crap, if I'm being completely honest. And he ain't scoring in the big games. I know it's difficult scoring against Real Madrid and Barcelona, but listen, we've seen Sheriff in the Champions League beat Real Madrid, you know, and we've seen these teams get upsets in that league. So maybe it's just the stat padding against the little teams is all he's good for. I don't know. He is only a young boy. He's 22 years old. So, but against Atletico, against Barca, and against Real Madrid in 6 games, no goals, no assists. And he's played in all 6 of them. So I don't know. His movement, whenever I've seen him, and like I said, I don't watch that league often, but when I have seen him, and I've seen him for Sweden a little bit here and there, his movement looks electric. He looks really quick as well. Very quick player, very nimble. But yeah, 40 mil, would you take him? Or is there other options out there that you think, oh, actually, maybe we could go and get an Ollie Watkins for that? I know a lot of you in the chat yesterday, in the comment section yesterday, were saying, oh, I don't really rate Watkins. We can do better. The problem I have is every time, and I said this yesterday, And a few people made some comments on it saying, yeah, but not every player from overseas comes and flops. No, granted, they don't. But when you look at the attacking positions in the Premier League from players that have come from outside of the Premier League, them three positions, or four positions if you want to drop the cam in there, right forward, left forward, striker, cam, them four positions, not many players come in and rip it up in this league. And when I say rip it up, I mean rip it up. Not just a couple of good appearances, score six goals in six games and then nothing for 10 games, then score two in two and then nothing for eight games. I mean, literally rip it up. So, yeah, I always take it with a pinch of salt when I see these stats of players. You have to look and see what games they've played in, look at the results, look at the minutes that they've played in them games. And he's played pretty much every minute of them games against the biggest teams and done nothing. So, like I said, does that mean anything? You tell me. Anyone who watches him religiously, anyone that's Swedish, anyone that's Eritrean, because that's where his heritage is, leave it in the comments section. I know I've got a few Eritrean brothers in the chat. Leave it in the comments section. I'll be back again at 11 p.m. I'm out of here. I'll tear out.